Listen, Eden is kingdom. An Eden mindset is a kingdom mindset.
Let me hear ya. Where my Eden citizens at? Where my Eden citizens at? Where you at? Let me see you do your hands like this. Here we go.
When God made man, he made a spirit. It was his plan that we live blessed. The tempter came, we were distracted.
So turn real quickly, let's turn to 1 Samuel chapter 30. Hallelujah!
Thank you, Lord.
I'm all there, y'all. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
1 Samuel chapter 30.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Ben, began reading at verse number 1. Everybody got it?
Yes, sir. Amen.
1 Samuel chapter 30. Read it first. Give me the verse number 1.
And it came to pass, when David and his men were come to Ziklag on the third day, that the Amalekites had invaded the south and Ziklag and smitten Ziklag and burnt it with fire and had taken the women captive that were therein.
Now, while David and the 600 men were away, the Amalekites had come and come and taken their wives and their children away.
That's right.
And took them captive.
That's right.
And so when they returned back, there was no wives and no children.
No children.
All right.
They didn't have a problem.
Yes, sir.
The boss said he had a problem.
Yeah.
Yeah. We think we have a problem. He had a major problem.
Yes, sir.
We don't.
Yes, sir.
They slew not any, either great or small, but carried them away and went on their way. So David and his men came to the city, and behold, it was burnt with fire.
Yeah.
And their wives and their sons and their daughters were taken captive. Then David and the people that were with him lifted up their voice and wept until they had no more power to weep.
But my brother, it was heavenly mourning. The wives were gone. The children were gone. They didn't know what had happened to them. They were gone. So they were mourning, crying, and they couldn't cry. They had a problem. Read on.
And David's two wives were taken captive. Ahiliam and the Jezreelitess. And Abigail, the wife of Nabal, the Carmelite. And David was greatly distressed.
He was what?
Greatly distressed.
He was greatly distressed. Why?
For the people spake of stoning him.
His own 600 men were looking at him crazy. Man, we went to war. We went with you. And because of you, our wives are gone. Our children are gone. Man, you deserve to die. I'm standing and look at you, King. David had a problem. He was distressed. He had a major problem.
Yes, sir.
And I like what David did. Read on.
Because the soul of all the people were grieved, every man for his sons and for his daughters. But David encouraged himself in the Lord his God.
What did David do?
Yeah.
He was a man after his own heart. God testified.
That's right.
He had a relationship. He knew just what to do. Wait a minute here. I'm going to get my eyes off these 600 men. I'm going to get my eyes off the negative circumstances. And I'm going to get it focused back on my King. The King of all kings.
In the Lord is God. And David said to
Read on. He encouraged himself.
And David said to Abiathar the priest, Abimelech, son, I pray thee, bring me hither the ephod.
Bring me the ephod.
Oh, yes.
Time to do something. I know what I'm going to have to do. Bring that ephod here.
Come on.
I ain't studying y'all looking at me.
I'm on control.
I ain't worried about this circumstance. I'm on control. My life is gone too. My children are gone too. I ain't worried about the trouble. I know what I got to do. Bring that ephod here.
And Abiathar brought thither the ephod to David.
What did David do?
And David inquired at the Lord.
What did he do?
Inquired at the Lord.
He left before God. He sought the Lord for the answer. He didn't lean to his own understanding. What did God do?
And David inquired at the Lord, saying, shall I pursue after this troop? Shall I pursue after this troop? Shall I overtake him? And he answered him, pursue.